Welcome to Subramani. What has happened for many of us, including older people, is that the perception of risk seems to be changing because the last two, three falls in the market have resulted in a V-shaped recovery. Even the 2008-2009, there was a V-shaped recovery, and 2020-21 was, of course, a super V-shaped recovery. The markets fell, of course, and the markets recovered very quickly, very fast, and hit new highs. Of course, the different set of shares may have hit a new high, but what happened was a few shares hit a new high, which meant people who were in the index did better, and those fund houses who were lucky enough, I wouldn't say smart enough, but lucky enough to have been in exactly those scripts did exceptionally well, which just led many people to believe that active funds in large cap will not outperform the index. I'm not commenting about it, but I recently saw PGIM saying 15 years they've gone up 21 times versus the index going up 15 times, right? So some of these outperformances will happen, but I'm not saying all large cap funds will outperform, but these things will happen. So let us look at risk from this point of view also. So first of all, when a small fund, let's say some fund house, which I don't want to name, I don't know, no fund likes to call itself small. It has some 75 crores in his mid cap fund, and it is doing very well. And so you have invested some money, and then when the market falls 20%, this fund falls by 30-32%. Fairly obvious that a lot of money will run away from this fund. So this fund, which had grown from say 75 crores to 150 crores, loses another 75-80 crores and comes back to 50-60 crores. Now 50-60 crores becomes very easy for the fund manager to manage, and then obviously everybody has pulled their money out, and then he manages it very well. So next time when the market is up 20%, his fund is up 45%. That's a sensational rock star performance which he has given. Now there are two sets of people. One, if I go and tell you this is XYZ fund of this fund house, you say, okay, it's indifferent, I did not invest, so it doesn't matter. Look at the person who had invested, who did not participate in much of the growth. He ended at the fag end of the journey and then he exited. Look at that guy, he's going to feel much worse. The impact is same, both have not made money, right? But the guy who invested and removed, right, he removed money, so he got hurt by his action, whereas the other guy just got hurt by his inaction. He did not invest that fund, so that's more easy for the mind to accept, saying it's okay, as long as we all heard stories of Wipro. You put 10,000 rupees in Wipro, it is worth 800 crores today, or stuff like that. If you did not invest in Wipro, you will live with it. But imagine if you had invested in Wipro and sold out a couple of years later. Say 1980, your father had applied in the IPO. In 1982, he thought it was good. His 10,000 had become 22,000 or something like that. And he happily sold in 2 years, saying, I have doubled my money, right? He hurts much more than the guy who never applied, right? So that is one thing. You are hurt more by your loss because of your action than by your inaction. Of course, this is in Thaler's book also, but there are so many books on behavioral finance. The second thing which hurts is anticipating something and then recalling something with and therefore thinking that is more important. What I think they only call it the Jaws syndrome. When the Jaws movie was released sometime in 1973-74, I've read that book 10 times and I can still get goosebumps when I talk about that book. It's an amazing book, extremely well written and beautifully picturized. So they came out with this movie and suddenly crowds at the beach went down because people thought every shark is going to come and bite them and eat them or kill them, whatever. Right, so that kind of a fear, because you can recall it, and if the fall is very dramatic, just imagine you bought the shares and next day it fell 20%, then again it fell 20%, then it was only sellers. Let's take even Reliance Capital. You bought Reliance Capital recently at 14 rupees, next day you found it at 12, next day you found it at 11, next third day you found it at 10. obviously you're going to hurt. Now, if you it is 14 rupees, so there's not much to lose. Yes, there is 14 rupees to lose, but then you buy big quantities. Let's say you bought 1 crore shares, then it's 14 crores at stake. You bought 1 lakh shares, then 14 lakhs is at stake, right? So the question is, those kind of risks which are dramatic for you to recall, you always think that those risks are much greater than the regular risk. For example, it is easy for people to get worried about COVID and cancer, or say a decade or 15 years ago it was AIDS, which scared people. But the much bigger killer could be your diet and lack of exercise, lack of preparing for retirement. Those could be your much bigger worries. But then they take away, they chip away, you know, 1 second every hour or things like that on your life, and that does not hurt you. You are worried about, in a typical Punjabi wedding in Delhi, you're worried about the bullet which escapes from some joker's rifle and kills you, right? That is a worry, because they bring rifles to show off. But the bigger killer could be the diabetes and the blood pressure caused by the rich diet, which people overeat, and that could be taking away 1 minute from every guest. Let's say there are 5,000 guests, then you're taking away maybe 1 hour from everybody's life, is 5,000 hours lost. That does not look as dangerous as this fear of a bullet hitting one person, right? The impact is the same. The amount of life lost is that many hours, right? Unfortunately, our mind thinks of each risk very differently. So like they say, Thaler calls it the Jaws syndrome. And yes, we tend to ignore those risks which we can't see. Many people would not even look at the depreciation which is happening in their assets, or appreciation which should have been happening in their portfolio, which is not happening. Those risks are not visible at all, right? So that's it. Thank you.